In this video, we take a look at how to create a flyer for handover service in Photoshop, and this is coming up. Hey everybody, it's Innocent here and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So here are the resources that I'll be using. Feel free to download it. A link will be in the description. Download and send me what you come up with, or send me what you design on Instagram and let's chat from there. So a link will be in the description if you want to download that. Now let's get into Photoshop and let's get started. So here in Photoshop, the first thing that we want to do is we want to create a new document, and we are doing this for social media, and I'm using Photoshop CS6. So go to File, New, and then you're going to create a new document. So at a preset here, let's go and choose Costume, and at the measuring scale, let's set this to inches. And we want to set 4x4 or 8x8 if you want your resolution to be very big. So let's go ahead and let's click OK. Now this is what we're going to use to do the design. So I've got everything as stated here, and that is what we're going to do. The whole concept is a handover, passing on something from a person to another one. So that is why I got picture of Elijah and Elisha, and I got pictures of people handing over sort of a marathon. So let's go into Photoshop, and then the first thing we want to create or add is a gradient overlay. So you go to the layer adjustment over here, and then you want to add a gradient. Now at the gradient section, you double click on the bar here, and then you can go into your gradients. If you are starting out, you might not have exactly these things over there, but then I've already set up the gradients. So this is the gradient that I'm going to use. So these are the hex codes if you want to use it. The first one is this, and then the second one is this one right over here. So once you're done with everything, you go ahead and you click OK. So at this point, all that you need to do is you head over to the style here, and you're going to click on that and change this to radial. Now at the scale here, I used 149, so use 149, and then you're going to reverse the whole gradient. Now once you're done, you go ahead and you click OK. Now let's go into the resource, and we have a couple of things to do, and we want to use this particular background here. So I got two of them, so you can use. So let's drag and drop this inside of Photoshop, and we want to place it right over here. Now you take your time to scale it to fill the entire canvas or the gradient, something like that. And then you want to right click on it, rasterize the layer. You want to press Ctrl Shift and then U to desaturate it, or better still, if you go to image adjustment and then desaturate over here, you can still find it. Now the next thing you want to do is go to the blending mode over here, and then you're going to set this one to overlay. Now you realize from here that this looks very solid, so what you do is you go to filter and then blur over here, and you go to Gaussian blur. Now we don't want this to be very so soft, so you're going to try to play around with the radius, and that is going to be on you. The more you increase it, the more it sort of fades away, and then you can't really see the picture in there. But it also doesn't have to be that very solid. So something like this would do, and then you can go ahead and click OK. Now this doesn't really make the whole thing very dark for me, so I'll go ahead and press Ctrl J to make another duplicate. But this time around, this duplicate also makes the whole thing very dark, so I'm going ahead to reduce the opacity to 50%. So I'll just type 50 on my keyboard, and this is the background that we are going to use. So for the next thing, we want to introduce in the handover image that I got from Google. So let me drag and drop, and then you realize from here that I also got two for you from here, so you can use any one of them. So I'll drag this and drop it inside of Photoshop over here. Now I'm going to rotate it, so I'll bring my cursor out of the box like that, and I'm going to left click and hold and rotate this one. Since the edges are already cut out, I would want to position it over here, and then you can take your time to resize it, something like that. So something like this, so that it will look as if the person is handing over the baton or whatever is in the hand to the person underneath. Now you want to take your time, and then you want to position it over here. Let me zoom in so that you see actually what I'm doing. So you want to make sure that the part that is cut off is right inside of Exactly. Okay, so once you have it like this, you can push it to the very extreme right, something like that, and then you're good to go. Now we want to add a bit of adjustment to it to tally with the background that we are using. So you right click on this one and then you can rasterize it. The first thing that you want to do is you want to decrease the saturation. So you press Ctrl plus U and then it opens the saturation for you, the hue and saturation. Now you're going to take the saturation down a little bit like that, so that it looks quite pale, and then you can press Ctrl L to activate the levels, and then you're going to take it down a little bit so that it looks quite darker. So once you have it like this, you're good to go. You add a layer mask to it, so you click on the layer mask and then you go for your brush, and then you make sure your foreground color is black, and then you can start brushing this area off so that it wouldn't look that very solid. You know, the part is already cut out, so you brush it off like this, and I think we are good to go. So the next thing that we're going to add will be the text and every other thing that is included. So let's start off by creating some grid lines or guidelines that is going to guide us in placing our text at the right place. So go to view and then guide or new guide over here, and then we want to type 9% or 8% over here. That is 8% to the very right side, and you go back to the view again, new guide, and then you deduct 8 from 100, making 92%, and that will go to the right side. So it means that from this portion to this side, everything is the same. Clear. Alright, so let's go ahead and add the first text. So I'll go for my text tool, and I'm going to use 4 different fonts in this video. I'll leave links in the description if you want to download any of them. So the first font that I'm going to use is called Railway. So I'll left click over here, and I've already done my typing, so I don't need to do it again. So I'm going to copy all of this one, and I did this for my school. Okay, so that is the name of my school. It has been changed from UEW to Amusted, almighty Amusted. So you select all of this one, and I'm going to select the medium for it. It is on left alignment because we want to align it to the grid that we set. You press Ctrl T and then you can transform this one to be a little bit smaller like that. I think the medium is still so tiny, and then let me just transform it some more over here. Okay, so I'll take my time to position it to the very edge of the grid line, and I'm going to select all of that, and I'm going to choose semi-bold. Yeah, semi-bold looks just fine. Once I have that, I'm going ahead to copy that, so I'll make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, and then I'll hold shift and drag it right beneath it. So I'll go back to my text, and I have the next text to be present, so I'm just going to copy that. I'll select this one and I'm going to paste it right over here. Now let me keep all of them in the caps lock. So let me go to toggle character over here, and I'm going to click on the all caps, that is the TT over here. So it means that whether the text is in caps or small letters, it is still going to be in all caps. Fair enough. So I'll try to position this one right over here, or you can keep it left aligned if you want to go with the left aligned style, and then I'll open it up a little bit. I'll double click on this one and I'm going to change the color to yellow. I'm trying to use the Methodist colors. Okay, so the blue, red, and then the yellow and white. So I'll go ahead and click OK from here. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to add another text, so I can easily copy this one again. So I'll make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, drag it to the very bottom, and I want to place it over here. Now we forgot to add one of the guidelines, so let's go to view and add the ultimate center guidelines, that is the 50%, and you click OK. So it means that I want my text to be in between this guideline and this particular guideline over here. Now here I'm going to introduce my second particular fonts. Remember, links will be in the description. So I'm going to select all of the presents here, and I'll go to the font family. I'm going to use a font called Trajan Pro. Link will be in the description. So what I do is I'll go into my text, and I'm going to copy the hand over here, and I'm going to paste it right over there. I'll take my time. I'll press Ctrl T to transform it to be a little bit bigger, and then I'll double click on that. Now I'll select all of it again, and I'm going to make it very bold. So instead of the regular, I'm going to use bold over here. I go to the tracking section over here and I'm going to set this to minus 60. That is to get it close up horizontally. Now once I'm done with that, I can take my time to open it up some more like this to make it a little bit bigger. Okay, so once that is done, I'll press Ctrl J again and I'm going to make a duplicate and I'll drag it to the very bottom of it. I'll select it all and I'm going to type in the over. So handover, very simple like that. So I'm going to select all of this again and I'm going to change the font color to white and I'll click OK. I'll take my time and select it plus the hand by pressing or holding Ctrl and I can resize it a little bit bigger and position it to the very top over here. Now we're going to add the next font and let me just bring in a guideline over here to make sure that everything will be online. So I'm going to select my text tool again and I'm going to type something over here. So I'm just going inside my text and I'm just going to copy the service over here and I'll paste it right like that. I'll select it all and go to the font family and I'm going to use a font called Tuesday Night. Links will be in the description. Now for this one, I don't want it to be all caps, so I'll go back to the toggle character and I'll make sure that the double T over here, that is all caps, is turned off, and then I can have my service in peace. Now I don't want it to be that very closed when it comes to horizontally, so I'll set this one also to zero. So I'll make sure that I drag it to the guideline that we set and then I can increase it up a little bit like that, so it is going to read the handover service, so something like that, and then you can leave it over there. Now the next thing that we want to add will be the date, the time, and then the venue. So let's first add the date. So beneath this one we want to go for the rounded rectangle and you can make adjustments to the radius if it doesn't fit for you. For instance, at 100 this is what you're going to have, but then when you make it to like 200 or 300 you're going to get it a lot more curved. So I'll maintain 100 and I'm going to create a very simple rounded rectangle over here, something quite simple like this one. I'll make sure that I press Ctrl A to center it very simply and I'm going to decrease the fill to 0%. Right click on it and go to the blending options. Now at the blending options, what I just want to add will be a stroke and then an outer glow. So I'll first add a stroke so that it can reveal the edges and I'm going to change that particular stroke to a very bright color, something like this one, and I'll click OK. Now I'll go to the outer glow over here as well and I'm going to increase the size to spread a lot more like that, and I'm going to change the color also to a particular color like this one so that it can also spread for me. Okay, so I'll decrease the size a little bit like that and then I can click OK. Now I want to press Ctrl T to transform it to be a little bit smaller as it looks so very big for me. So from there I'm going to introduce my fourth and last font and that is going to be Poppins. So I'll create a text over here, change the font to Poppins, and then I'm going to use the very semi-bold. Now I'll go into my text and I have Sunday. I actually created this on Sunday, 17th January. Okay, so I'm just going to select all of this one and I'm going to make sure that I center it. So you center it like that, and then the bold, I think it's too bold, so let me just go for the medium right over there. Right, so I'll press Ctrl T and then I'm going to transform this one to be a lot more smaller and then I'm going to send it to the rounded rectangle that we created. So I'm going to send it right over here and then that is the job of the date. Now we go ahead and then we're going to pick the rectangle to, we're going to create a white rectangle at the very bottom of all of this one. And I'm going to change the color to white over here and then I'll click OK. Now let me select the date and then the rounded rectangle and let me try to push it to the very top a little bit and push the rectangle also a little bit down so that there can be space between them. And then that is where we're going to put the venue and then any other information. So we just want to go back to the Sunday, that is the date. We're going to make a duplicate and we send it on top of the rectangle. Now we're going to drag it over here so you can see it right over there. I'll double click on it and I'm going to change the color to red. Okay, so let me maintain blue for now. So I'm just going to maintain blue over there, and then I'll drag it onto this particular one. Since it is all left aligned, we don't really have to worry ourselves. So I'll go inside my test over here, and I have the new building, that is the venue. So I'll copy that and I'll paste it right over here. Now let me select all of this one and try to go for the regular, as this looks very bold. I'll press Ctrl T and then I'm going to transform it to fit exactly this place, so something like this, and then I'll position it over here. I'll use the arrow keys and I'll bring it down a little bit like this. So what we're going to do is going to make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J, and then you send it to the extreme right over here, and then you go into your test, and then you're going to copy the other information as well. So you copy that and then you're going to paste it right over here. So let's select all of that and change the color back to red, and that is going to be the information. So after you're done with everything, the last thing that we want to do is we want to add the logos to it. Let's go back and select the Ghana Methodist over here, and then we go into our resource, and I've intentionally grouped the logos so that I wouldn't stress on that as well. So you drag and drop it inside of Photoshop, and then you can position it over here. You press Ctrl T or use the transformation controls, and then you can resize them very neatly and drag it to the extreme left side over here. Yeah, so after you're done with everything, you can go ahead and press Ctrl H to turn off all the guidelines, and this is what you're having. And then you can take time to group your work so that it looks quite good. So you can select this one, for instance, hold shift and select to the last point, that is the Sunday. You press Ctrl G and then you can group that to date and venue, or let's give it something like that, date and venue. And then you can select from the rounded rectangle. Oh, the rounded rectangle is part of this one, so you can push it inside there as well. And then you can select from the service to the handover, and you can group that also to the main. So let's give it the main. And then from the presents to the Ghana Methodist, and the replay, that is going to be the heading. So let's give this one heading. And then you can group the background as well. So you double click on it and then you can give this one background. So that is it. That is how to create a very simple church flyer for handover service purposes. And if you group your works, it makes it easier for you to re-edit them anytime you give it to someone or you want to edit it yourself. And that'll be it for this video. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. It's Innocent here, and bye.